welcome to Championship Wrestling. This is Vince McMahon here at ringside, along with wrestling's living legend, Bruno Sammartino. And this week on hand to start things off will be the Tonga Kid.
Hey, this guy's really exciting. I think people have fallen in love with him. He's showing nothing but excitement, fire in that ring, and he's gonna go all the way.
And yet another workout session, if he can hack it, with the World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan really putting the test to the Hillbilly Jim.
Hey, some kind of workouts from what I've seen, and I'll tell you what, Big Jim is going right through them.
He sure is. We'll look forward to that workout session. Also on hand this week, an unbelievable tag team combination in giant-like Big John Studd and the Olympian Ken Patera once again joining forces. But right now, without further ado, let's take you up to ringside to begin the first matchup.
This contest is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the ring at this time, from Mesquite, Texas, weighing 283 pounds, Mike Powers. And his opponent, from the Isle of Tonga, weighing 225 pounds, the Tonga Kid.
The Tonga Kid over the top rope. And my goodness, these fans really behind the Tonga Kid. Tonga Kid, of course, the cousin of one Superfly, Jimmy Snuka. We've seen them many times in tag team action. Right now, Mike Power going to work. Well, no. Tonga just the other way around. Tonga Kid reversing things, snaps him over, down he goes.
Well, this Power should try to take the advantage in the beginning, but he was a little too slow for that Tonga Kid, who's got fire legs, just tremendous speed.
Alter rope, Mike Power, and right down to the canvas. Power attempting to take a cheap shot at the Tonga Kid earlier on. That did not pay off, as it most often does not. Capacity crowd here this week. Jam-packing the arena. And down to the canvas again goes Mike Power. Tonga leaning back into his man and pulling up on the forearm at the same time. That's not a pleasant position to be in, is it, Bruno?
No, it is not.
Power?
It is not. And Tonga had a really pretty good hold on it. And he kind of pushed his weight in the lower by the solar plexus of Mike Powers, which was cutting down on his wind. But now let's see, he's throwing Tonga Kid to the ropes. Big tackle.
Yes, nice shoulder block by the Tonga Kid. It's now the Tonga Kid and Mike Power back up, way up, as a matter of fact. And a slam with authority as the Tonga Kid comes off to drive the right hand. A cover, hooks the leg, it's no, not quite. Power on his feet has shown very little, actually, in the way of an offense since attacking the Tonga Kid earlier on from behind.
Powers is a big man, as we can see. He's got a lot of weight on him, but he doesn't have the fire. Look at this, watch his punches. He really doesn't put an awful lot of steam behind him. Now that will hurt no matter what. Well, it hurts with most people, but not the Tonga Kid.
Oh my, Tonga Kid getting himself up. Power snapped right over. Referee right there, making sure that Power does not want to call it quits at this juncture. He may be thinking about it.
Come on, right back to you. We seen it. We seen it. That's okay. Yes. Yes.
Power really not doing anything at all. Oh, yes, he is there. A rake in the face. Tonga Kid staying right on top of him, and may have a thumb. Uh-oh, he's inching his way to the rope, hooks the rope. Referee will ask for the clean break. Power has an opportunity to kind of get himself together. Probably a welcomed opportunity.
But you look at Power, she looks almost groggy. He looks like he's tired. He looks like he's dizzy or something.
Tonga Kid bringing Power right back over in a position that we have seen a lot of thus far in this match. Power on the canvas. And Power has displayed anything but power. There, again, Tonga Kid with him up. Drives the knee to the kidney area, and that may be it. Tonga Kid out of the apron. Tonga Kid all the way up to the top rope. Power not moving. Here he comes. Oh, and a headshot. Cover, look out, and it's lights out. Very impressive victory for the 18-year-old Tonga Kid.
Here is your winner, the Tonga Kid.
Tonga Kid with so many, many fans about ringside, and he can really electrify an audience. As we take you now back, yes, that's Jimmy and Tonga. Here we go.
Look at this, Vince. He picks him up and brings him right down on his knee. Now, that really hurt Powers. Really hurt his back and knocked some wind out of it. But now here's Tonga. He goes up the top rope, and when he leaps off, he comes with a headbutt that is so devastating. Well, as we can see, Powers already out of commission, but after this blow, he's going no place. Look at this.
Unbelievable. Off that rope, and...
Look at that.
Yeah, wow.
Incredible.
I would think that is incredible. I would think that would take as much out of Tonga as it does out of his opponents, but obviously, that's not the case. The Tonga Kid, and he is a boy wonder at 18 years old. Unbelievable. The Tonga Kid doing his thing. Let's take you now to some special footage concerning Cyndi Lauper, Lou Albano, and the incredible Hulk Hogan.
And now, we take you to New York's famous nightclub, Studio 54, where Captain Lou Albano and Cyndi Lauper will talk to a very special celebrity guest.
With a 10-minute time limit, it is a non-title match. In the ring at this time, from Miami, Florida, weighing 280 pounds, Joe Myrto. His opponent, from Seattle, Washington, weighing 250 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
There's a good look at the reigning Intercontinental Champion. This is a non-title matchup, of course. Greg Valentine. Boy, is he ever a competitor.
Well, so far, he's defended his title many a time and always successfully, so... What can you say? He certainly is a successful champion.
And you can hear the chant bill. Championship belt in the air a moment ago. Valentine with a little assistance, of course, victorious over Mr. Santana on that fateful occasion when he became Intercontinental Champion.
It'll be most interesting to see how Mr. Valentine fares without the presence of Luis Albano. There has been, apparently, somewhat of a falling out between Mr. Albano and Greg Valentine.
Yeah, I've heard that. I wonder what that's all about, huh? I guess we won't know. Look at this. Here's Myrtle, who's a big, big man. And Valentine over his lock. Oh, but there's an arm drag by Myrtle. That's surprising. Valentine fell into that.
Myrtle, big, powerful man. Pickers against Greg Valentine. A lot of rough movements. Myrtle's in a rope now. Valentine perhaps had his cage just when an opponent against the rope, and yes, that's no exception. A series of forearms.
Yeah, I was going to say, that was surprising. After Valentine gave him that drop toe hold for Myrtle to get up as he did and to catch Valentine with that arm drag, I wouldn't have expected that. I think it got Valentine by surprise. But now Myrtle, I think, is paying for it because that upset Valentine.
The elbow striking the lower abdominal area. It was not a low blow. Referee right there on the money.
Yeah.
And again, the driving of the knees. Valentine uses his legs so very effectively. And what a hammer he can drop on the back.
Oh boy, does he have. Now here's a guy who really knows. Oh, now this is going to be a vertical suplex.
I don't think he can get him up. Oh my goodness.
Got him up easy.
He sure did. Valentine winding up, drops the hammer into the chest area of Joe Myrtle. Valentine, known for the specialty. The figure four leg lock, spinning toe hold, now wraps it around. Cinches the leg way down. Looks like he has it really cinched up now. Valentine with a figure four leg lock. And that one hold takes Valentine on to yet another victory. Let's get the official decision.
Here is your winner, the Intercontinental Champion, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Greg Valentine, victorious in a very impressive fashion. And I'm sure his opponent, Joe Myrtle, will remember the pain that he experienced moments ago. Pain which sometimes can be a very long-lasting occasion.
Look at this. He gives him this devastating elbow. Now, this, I believe, was in midsection here. Let's see. Oh, he had already delivered the elbow. This is after the elbow. Then he puts on the figure four leg lock. And, of course, nobody puts it on better than Valentine. And as soon as he applied it, Myrtle gave up.
Let's take you to a special interview.
All right, fans, stay tuned. More exciting World Wrestling Federation action coming up in just a moment or two. By the way, back in the Boston Garden here in town Saturday night, February the 2nd. And what a card. Right out of the chute, I've got to mention, in a return bout, Texas Tornado tag team match, all four men of the ring at the same time, Big John Studd teaming up with Ken Patera, and their tag team opponents will be Andre the Giant and the Junkyard Dog. More, certainly on that later. Mike Rotundo, Barry Windham, gentlemen, come on in if you would, please. Mike, one-on-one against the former World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champ, the Iron Sheik.
You know, the Iron Sheik is from Iran, and right here you're looking at a boy born in the USA. This is my chance to show the people in Boston what the Americas has left in it. I've trained all my life at Syracuse University, then I turned professional. Iron Sheik, I know you've trained all your life, but I'm going to show you what a boy born right here on the streets of Boston, on the streets of New York, in Chicago, it doesn't matter where you're from, you're born in the USA. And I'm going to show you what it's all about, U.S. style.
All right, speaking of the USA, you're going to be representing our fair country, Barry Windham, your opponent from Russia, Nikolai Volkov.
Gene, you know what happened here? Now, we showed these two boys exactly what we could do in a tag team situation, and they both took off out of the ring and didn't want to come back. So what we're going to do, we're going to take them on singly this time and just show everybody exactly what we can do. Now, we're going to have to be watching each other's back during this. We're going to be watching for the Sheik coming in. I'm going to be watching Volkov during Mike's match. And what we're going to do is we're going to show them exactly how it's done in the good old USA.
In the good old USA, Mike Rotundo, Barry Windham, representing this fair country of ours, the Boston Garden, February the 2nd. Stay tuned. We're going to be right back after this.
Morning, Hillbilly. I sure am glad to see you're on time today.
Yeah.
Man, how you feeling?
Oh, bud, hey, I feel so good. I feel like I could go bear hunting with a big old switch.
Well, bow up a little bit. Let me see how big you're getting. Man, you know, Hillbilly, you look like one of them bears. Turn around. Man, you're just like one of them big old oak trees I've seen out there in the woods. You know something? You've come along so strong, I can't wait. All this week, it's going to be better than the last few weeks. Yeah, go ahead, drink your breakfast.
I love that stuff, that's good. I tell you, it's good, but you know, when you first started giving me that stuff, I thought that stuff was going to hurt me, huh?
That's my idea.
Yeah. I thought this stuff was going to hurt me, but I'll tell you what, I'm doing my chores a lot better.
Well, that's right. I knew you'd been working out real hard and sticking with it, but the chores have come along better.
Yeah, a lot better, a lot easier.
I tell you what, let's do the normal thing, head on down to the gym, and I think when we get done, I might have you drink some more of this python powder, because I got some special raw eggs in there this week that I snuck in there on you, and it's going to make you twice as powerful, just like all them
good beer.
Let's do it. Come on.
All right.
Drink to the chores.
Don't worry about wrestling.
When do I get to wrestling?
Don't worry about it. You know, your legs are getting stronger, but you're still a little uncoordinated.
Hold it.
You know, the legs are getting...
Just want to get in that ring.
I told you, you're getting better and better every week, but you got to get more coordinated. Your legs are definitely getting a lot stronger.
I feel better.
You know,
I feel a lot better.
Let's see you hit those ropes again. Let's see if you're getting better hitting the ropes.
Come on.
Come on, Hillbilly. Hit them hard, man. Use them as a weapon. Hit them hard. Okay, hold it, Hillbilly, hold it, whoa.
It's better?
Yeah, you're getting a lot better.
Huh?
Well, you're not ready to wrestle.
That's all I want to do, Hulk. I just want to wrestle and get that ring.
You know, you've got a long way to go with the weightlifting.
But I'm ready.
I know you're almost ready. You're still the one coordinated. We've got to teach you some wrestling holds. And you know, you're definitely getting stronger, but it's going to take a while. You've got to understand it's going to take a while before you wrestle.
But I want to do it. I want to do it real bad, Hulk. That's all I want to do.
Hillbilly, what? Hold on. You know, just because you beat a bear in the circus, how would you beat a wrestler? I mean, these guys know all the moves.
Why? I'm doing just like I did that bear. I just did.
Hillbilly, let him down. Let him go. Hillbilly, let him go.
I didn't mean to hurt that fella.
Oh, man.
Sorry,
Hillbilly, you got to calm down.
Listen, I didn't mean to hurt you. Okay,
the guy's been helping you out. Look.
Yeah, he's a good fella. I didn't mean to hurt you there.
Hold on.
I'm sorry.
You know something? You're one of the most determined guys I've ever seen. You're not in shape. You're not ready to wrestle. But I tell you what, you want it so bad, you give me a couple weeks, Hillbilly. And if I can get
you
a match.
Real, man. I really want it.
If I can get you a match, give me a couple weeks, and I'll stick you in the ring, and even though you're not ready, I'll stand behind you all the way.
All right, that's all I want, though. That's all
I want. Be careful, man. Jeez.
I will. That's all I want.
Be careful. Come on. Jeez.
Ladies and gentlemen, back in the Boston Garden, Saturday, February the 2nd. By the way, side of that card, the World Wrestling Federation Ladies Champion, Wendy Richter, to defend that coveted title of hers against none other than Judy Martin. I'll be talking with the Ladies Champion a little bit later on. Ivan Putski and Polish Power to go against Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. And after last Saturday night, Andre the Giant, apparently the promoters making a decision that you asked for it. In a return bout, Foreman of the Ring all at the same time, Texas Tornado Tag Team Bout, Junkyard Dog and yourself, and another shot at Stud and Patera.
That's what I learned when I was out. Blackjack took me in Texas and he showed me what it is about Texas Tornado Deathmatch. John Stud and Ken Patera, you got disqualified last Saturday. But this time, maybe you get disqualified again. We never know, but show up again, because believe me, I'm never going to be tired to wrestling against you guys. I'm going to chase you all over the country, but this time in Boston again, we're going to do it. Ken Patera and John Studd, you maybe cut my hair. I don't go for revenge, but I'm going to take my time. I don't know how long it will take, but the only thing I want to do is to get even, and believe me, I'm going to do it.
You know, all four men in the ring at the same time. That's guaranteed bedlam in itself. You got a pretty good man at your side, too, the Junkyard Dog.
You're going to be there, and even if he needs the chain he got, we're going to tie up those guys against the ring. And maybe that'll be the way we go. Get even.
All right. You don't get mad. You get even.
Right.
Andre the Giant teaming up with JYD, Junkyard Dog, Patera Stud, their opponents, in a return Texas Tornado match here on February 2. We're right back.
Match scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first in the ring, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 248 pounds, R.T. Reynolds. His partner from parts unknown, weight unknown, Mr. X. And their opponents, from Sweetwater, Texas, weighing 240 pounds, Barry Windham. And from Syracuse, New York, at 238 pounds, Mike Rotundo.
Yes, indeed. The American Express. The tag team combination. Mike Rotundo, Barry Windham. They are really electrifying fans as well as, unfortunately, on many an occasion, opponents throughout the World Wrestling Federation. Starting things off now, it's big ol' R.T. Reynolds against Barry Windham. Here we go. Arm drag takedown, nicely done by Reynolds. Windham, I think, gets bigger every week.
Yeah, he certainly is a big boy, but I like a guy that size that can move so quickly. He does those arm drags with such terrific speed for a guy 6'6". That is really amazing. Not too many people at that height can do those kind of maneuvers with such speed, such finesse.
Windham and RT locking back up now. Side headlock by RT Reynolds. Sort of a forearm to the kidney area, trying to back off RT a little bit. Setting him up, obviously, now, and nice maneuver by RT. Over Barry Windham, right back at him, but Windham catches him with his feet. Oh, wow. RT all the way outside. Windham timing that maneuver perfectly. And that's one of the things that Rotundo and Windham have so much of, it all-important element of timing.
They certainly do, and it means so much. Like, as you say, he timed that so perfectly. And being as tall as he is, when he monkey flipped at Reynolds, I mean, he really put some leg power into it, and he practically made it fly out of the ring.
X now in the ring. And X trying to make a maneuver. Meanwhile, the tag is made to Mike Rotundo. Uh-oh, wide open X. Oh, downstairs. Up goes X. Slammed in a canvas. Dropping an elbow. Mike Rotundo covers him. Well, that'll put the cobwebs in the head. Mr. X now wound up by Barry Windham. Collision. Oh, my. Cover. RT. Oh, look what RT did. Made. Windham whipping X to the rope. Up and over now, and round and round. Airplane spin. Oh, look at that. Cover. 1, 2, 3, yes, sir. Barry Windham. Mike Rotundo. What a victory. American Express. Mike Rotundo, Barry Windham, let's take you to what we saw just moments ago.
Well, here we go. When Rotundo came in, he took the Max, Mr. X on an airplane spin, and then when Reynolds came in, he got caught with the feet of Mr. X, went driving him down, and of course, when he took him down, that was it. He does a beautiful spin, so with such speed, fantastic.
What philosophy on this spin. Awaiting us now, ladies and gentlemen, Roddy Piper. Let's take you to Piper's Pit.
Everybody's just so excited because we have the world's heavyweight champions here. And I want you to know that I tried to find Jack and Jerry Briscoe, and I went over and tried to find in Oklahoma where they live, and some tobacco chewers. I looked at a teepee and I found a cheap bottle of wine there that the Briscoes have been drinking. And I said to myself, with great heavyweight champions like this, and I'm looking at this teepee and it's got Briscoes over top of it, a real classy place, I'm saying to myself, how can the Briscoes possibly have beaten the world's heavyweight champions right on national television in front of everybody? It don't make no sense to me.
They didn't beat us. We were sick. We had the flu the last time we were here, the last time we wrestled the Briscoes. And doctors even told us not to show up, right, Adrian? The doctors told us and advised us not to wrestle.
I thought there was something. There was a double pneumonia because they had both of you in the ring at the same time.
I had the Taiwan flu. I was sick to death. 104 fever. I got out of bed to show what I'm made of.
There you go. You see, I knew that there was something wrong, especially when I looked. I know the Briscoes are former world's heavyweight champions. I know all that stuff. But with people like the Briscoes, they're coming up and they're saying they deserve a title shot at you now.
Well, you know, it seems that Jack and Jerry Briscoe, the last of the Akawis, think they're big stuff. Cry to the promoters, do they? They want a title shot? There's other teams in line, Daddy. Isn't that right, Dick? Frankie Williams? Rivera.
Yes, there's lots of teams.
That's right. You know, Roddy, we are definitely back. We're definitely healthy now. We're back in shape and line up.
You figure the Briscoes are in shape? Just a little cheap wine. These are the people that you people.
Could I hold it? Could I hold it?
These are real champions, and these are what champions are made of, not the Briscoes.
For one fall. With a 10-minute time limit, introducing first to my left, from Tocula, Mexico, weighing 244 pounds, Tito Santana. His opponent, from Danbury, Connecticut, weighing 238 pounds, Paul Kelly.
I believe the very first appearance of Paul Kelly against Tito Santana.
And it's really nice to see the former Intercontinental Champion back in such tip-top shape. Nice maneuver there on the part of Kelly, however. A series of reverses. Kelly goes down, and Santana right up with him. Kelly a little caught off guard, I think.
Yeah, but Kelly, he moved pretty well, although, you know, of course, Santana's so clever, he outmaneuvered him. But I never seen Kelly. I don't know too much about him, but he impressed me a little wee bit the way he came at Santana.
Careful. And look at that, right back up. My goodness, Santana's lightning like quick. Kelly, go right over him now. Santana up. Oh! Ah. Kelly up in the air again and on the slam. Kelly arm drag, takedown, and Santana is really taking it to Paul Kelly.
That's pretty hard to outmaneuver Santana. He's got such lightning speed. He's so quick. He's got such great balance. I'll tell you, he's really exciting to watch in that ring.
Commentary takedown, one of your more basic maneuvers, and certainly one of the successful ones. See the... To our left, it's Santana's right knee. Still bandaged and protected somewhat. Many of you will recall, thanks to Greg Valentine, Mr. Santana, having to undergo some surgery to the knee area. And allegedly, it is back at 100% capacity. We've been watching it very closely, Bruno. Do you think it's back at 100% capacity?
I believe so, because I'm watching his moves in that ring. He shows no sign whatsoever of any pain or anything. He's 100%. There's no question about it. It's just that sometimes it's psychologically, you want to protect it, but there's nothing wrong.
Kelly now, whipped to the rope, Santana. Oh, nice maneuver by Kelly. Off the ropes again, Santana leapfrog now. Kelly coming back, nice maneuver. And down to the canvas again, Paul Kelly. And Santana really rocking back.
Boy, I'll tell you, this Kelly is trying. It's just that Tito's just too fast for him, just too good for him. But he certainly is aggressive. He's trying to make something work for him, but just nothing working so far.
Kelly taking it to Santana. Well, it was a moment ago. Santana firing back with a fury. With the rope, Santana sets him up. Back body drop. Santana with Kelly out in the middle of the ring. Going to work with the left leg of Paul Kelly. Now, wrapping him up. The right leg, and then what's he going to do? Yes, figure four leg lock. Greg Valentine, not the only individual who apparently has perfected the use of the figure four leg lock. And the referee, as a matter of fact, having to untangle Santana. Such was the way the hole was really cinched in there.
He really locked it in. He locked it in so that he couldn't reach it himself. It took the help of the referee. And Kelly is hurting.
Here is your winner, Tito Santana.
Tito Santana, victorious. Mr. Santana really on a tear as of late, hoping to regain the Intercontinental Championship.
Look at this. He really, really spun that leg around and then sets it up. And here he goes down, hooks it with his own leg and perfect, sets it up perfectly. Look at that.
Let's take you to Hawaii and to the magnificent Morocco.
From that Pacific paradise, Hawaii, the magnificent Morocco and Mr. Fuji.
All the spirits in the valley are rejoicing. They know. They know that the violence will return to the WWF. They know the snowfall and the sunshine will come and will melt back the rain of Hulkamania. They know that magnificence is just a short time away.
It's a tag team match scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. In the ring at this time, from San Benito, Texas, weighing 234 pounds, Aldo Moreno. His partner from New York City, weighing 236 pounds, Jim Powers. And their opponents will be led to the ring by their manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. From Portland, Oregon, weighing 267 pounds, Olympic strongman Ken Patera. And his partner from Los Angeles, California, weighing 367 pounds, Big John Studd.
Big John Studd along with Ken Patera, they are greeted by a round of boos and thumbs down. And certainly all of these fans from coast to coast who remember what happened not long ago with Ken Patera, Big John Studd, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and disgracing or attempting to disgrace Andre the Giant.
The fans may not forget it, Vince, but neither is Andre the Giant.
Yes, Hulkamania, you bet. Saw the Hulkster earlier on. John Dutt. Ken Patera, the first human being to ever military press 500 pounds. I think he looks just as good at this moment, maybe even better than when he set all of the Olympic records he set.
I think he looks better now, best he's ever looked, because when he set those records, he had to carry more weight, which for wrestling wouldn't be as good because that kind of weight will slow you down. But right now, Patera is extremely strong, but he moves really, really quick, and he's got much more stamina and speed.
Look at that. Oh, my. Patera dropping the elbow.
Vince, that Jim Powers is a fine-looking athlete, too.
He definitely is, and in the ring at the moment is a mountain of a man. He is, well, he calls himself the giant of wrestling, and he definitely is a giant of wrestling. Not 267 pounds, 367.
Aldo Moreno just made a mistake. He turned around with the people while they were chanting. And John Studd went over and just laid that big, big, powerful forearm right in the back of his neck.
Big John Studd, with his opponent almost helpless now, drives him to the buckle. It's really tough to imagine just how massive Big John Studd is. Bobby Brain Heenan certainly looking on and enjoying the action at the moment.
Yeah, he's a very happy guy, Heenan, right now, because he's watching two of the most powerful people in the world having things completely under control in that ring.
And Heenan, credited for being able to make this combination gel as a unit.
I'll tell you, that it's got to be the most powerful team in wrestling history. And it'd be interesting to see what team can be put together to give these two any real stiff competition.
Aldo Moreno in the corner with Ken Patera as Patera elbows his way out. Aldo with a stiff right hand. In the wrong part of town. Forearm smash. Patera with another forearm to the head. And now Big John with Aldo Moreno. One side of the ring. Oh, my. Big John Studd lumbering over. Hip toss. And Big John's height. That's almost like a body slam from a normal sized wrestler. Studd just unfolds. There, he certainly could have had a count of three.
He certainly could have. You know, and Marino, he's not a little guy by any means. Just watching him in there with Studd looks like David and Goliath in there.
Kid Patera covering Aldo Marino. A I think Patera also could have had a three count.
Absolutely.
Ben Patera and Big John Studd having fun in there this week. Lots of it. Ooh, ah! And I think Studd was asking for yes. Ooh, that, ladies and gentlemen, Ben Patera, when he gets that hold on you at full Nelson, he can really make you cry, Uncle. Ben Patera, look at
him. Hey, let's go,
Patera. That can inflict some permanent damage. Patera still hanging on to the hole. Finally releasing the hole. Ken Patera and Big John Studd. A force to reckon with. We're going to have a special interview, after which a final word on next week's card. Stay with us, but let's take you now to the interview.
Fans, get ready. Saturday night, February the 2nd, here in Boston at the Boston Garden. Fantastic World Wrestling Federation spectacular in the making. In a return bout, it is going to be a Texas Tornado-style tag team bout. Four men of the ring all at one time. Those four men, Ken Patera, Big John Studd. On the other side, the Junkyard Dog and Andre the Giant. In addition, Barry Windham to meet Russia Nikolai Volkov, and also Ivan Putski going against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Wendy Richter, come on in. I had to bring in the ladies' champion here in the World Wrestling Federation. We told you the
to help you. Now, I'm asking you, intelligent American man, you tell that Boston, Massachusetts people, but I confirm, and what is my background is. Well, tell to that
I'll
people.
Be more than happy, and especially this is the home of Harvard University.
Exactly.
And many other universities. One of the greatest from the Middle East of all time, from Tehran, Iran. A standout in the Pan Am Games, also in the 1968 Olympics in Mexico City. And I believe there's another tournament in Turkey, you...
How about the world heavyweight
yes.
champion right. belts? How about that? Tell it, tell it.
And also a former World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion.
You punk. You want to make sure that the reputation come wrestling with the Sheik? After you're done with me, your mama not going to recognize you. Your neighbor not going to recognize you. And after that...
Unfortunately, we were blocked again in our efforts.
We will at some time, I'm sure, be granted the rights to show you what happened in that melee in Madison Square Garden during the awards presentation. But nonetheless, Hulk Hogan has demonstrated that, well, apparently as Hillbilly Jim, really on the right sort of trail in training, and apparently claims in a couple of weeks' time he'll unveil the Hillbilly.
Well, I understand the Hillbilly's making some fantastic, fantastic progress, and for him to be appearing, Hogan must feel that he's ready.
And speaking of the Hulkster, in a non-title matchup, yes, indeed, next week, the reigning World Wrestling Federation champion will join us, the Hogan. Also to join us next week, here on Championship Wrestling, will be the likes of Brutus Beefcake, along with a big man in his own right, Blackjack Mulligan, and look out, the Junkyard Dog on his way next week to Championship Wrestling, along with Rowdy Roddy Piper, his special edition of Piper's Pit, the tag team combination of Big John Studd and Ken Patera, plus a special update. All of this and more right here next week for more of Championship Wrestling. Until then, this is Vince McMahon, along with wrestling's living legend, Bruno Sammartino, saying so long from ringside.